I'm the director, he's the producer. Well, actually, we're both kind of the producers, and we wrote this story, and we came up with all the ideas for, the film?
Yeah, the film.
It's great, just that, I mean, out of all the movies that he and I have done together, here's, like, a big accomplishment.
Yeah, this is probably the best one.
Because actually the idea formed in my head when I was actually taking a shower a few days ago, and I know that sounds so weird.
There was actually this one scene where a kid was looking out the window and I had to improvise, and I actually threw the doll at him.
So there was kind of a casting process too, that was really hard, because for the main character, we really don't have, for the characters, we don't have, names or anything, since none of the characters talked or anything.
And yeah, it's weird, yeah. Kind of silence. It took me a while to realize that.
And the strangest thing about it is actually just that the dolls are actually doing,
more work than the people.
Yeah, it's strange. And I would have to say that the dolls, I can't thank my mom enough, or the person who actually decided to go out and buy these creepy dolls for my mom when she was about
5 years old.
5 years old, and then, here you go, honey, I got you a birthday present.
It's like, what's a 5-year-old gonna do with this? I mean, if I was 5 and somebody gave it to me, like, back then, I would have went nuts.
Yeah, just that I think I would it possibly burn it, like
in Child's Play.
Yeah. I would just also like for everyone to know there, this is not copying Child's Play at all, because
it's not a thing like Child's
no,
Play.
No, I'm just
it's creepier, not like gory, but creepy.
Yeah, because that was my whole intention when I had the idea. My whole intention was not to be gory. It was wanted to be like very creepy, suspenseful, a bit dark and eerie. And he is like all about, blood, guts, and gore.
Guilty as charged.
Not all the time, but just that. But he really helps me out when he sees things that I'm doing wrong, because he's the horror movie
expert.
Yeah, fanatic.
Fanatic?
Yeah, just
I wouldn't say fanatic.
Okay.
Well, yeah, fanatic.
That's because he's seen everything from, the oldies to, like, the 21st century crap.
Yeah, 21st century crap.
Just the thing that we joke about all the time is when we actually got done with the whole project, which at the moment we are not completely done, but just that, but when we're gonna post this, we're gonna be all done, so,
Yeah, it started at, like, 3 o'clock, it's now 1:30.
Yeah, and so when he means 3 o'clock, or 2 o'clock, like 3 o'clock in the afternoon, right?
When, yeah, 3 o'clock.
And so we've been doing this for several hours, filming and then going on to our software system, the Mac.
And it's only been, the movie's only like 7 minutes.
It's a MacBook Pro. I love Apple. Thank you, Steve Jobs. Cannot thank everybody at Apple enough for
we love you, Apple.
Yeah. Just PC. Just absurd PCs, but you suck balls. That's alright. Apple is my life. That the main idea I had right when I got out of the shower was it was going to be a suspense film with this kid, and he wakes up from this horrible dream or nightmare, and he hears this weird noise at the front door, like someone's trying to ring the doorbell or knock at the front door.
The idea of the doll didn't come until I saw that creepy raggedy Ann doll.
Later. Where did you find that?
I found it in the bathroom.
Probably the laundry room.
Laundry room.
Yeah, and I can understand why that would probably be there, because it's like my mom got it from her great grandmother, I think.
Yeah.
They're both really old dolls, so just in the process of trying to use the dolls in the film, we also had to be very gentle. some of our not as intelligent actors weren't.
Like this one kid, there's actually a scene where I had to show him how to hold the doll. So it looked like he was looking out the window.
Also, one of the biggest accomplishments that we're so happy with this film is
we beat Paranormal Activity.
I'm not joking. Paranormal Activity
sucked ass.
When I first heard of it, I was like, well, I think they might do a pretty good job on it. But then he actually told me, no, it's actually one of the worst movies I've ever seen. And I didn't believe him.
And then I sat down and watched.
And they're actually just walking around holding a camera. And they don't even have... they're barely using a tripod.
That's what gave us the whole idea to shoot this, because...
Yeah.
We said we could do better than that.
And so we have no budget. We're doing everything with our own things. We're creating everything.
Virtually no budget.
And I would just have to say, if you are an inspired filmmaker, actor, or anything, just go for it. Even if your dad says it's a crappy waste of time and you should be outside doing something more productive.
Even when it's raining.
Yeah, sure, do that. So, I can't thank you guys enough. I'm Misha. He's Chris.
Yeah, Chris.
And we shot this, all this in the film with
HD camera on a crappy tripod.
And a crappy tripod, so.
And this is Raggedy Ann.
And even if you don't have a crappy tripod, just try.
Use a better tripod.
You all should be so proud of yourselves for actually watching this whole thing.
Yeah.